Hi everyone, and welcome to Billy Fitzgerald Golf. And tonight we're gonna answer that age-old question, how do I start my swing? Well, in my opinion, the head of the golf club should start your swing. It has the farthest to travel. This golf club has about 9 times as far as my shoulders. And what I like to think, or how I like to think about it, is that the golf club starts a chain reaction in what's happening. Since this has the farthest to travel, and it's pretty much the most important part of the swing because it's the only thing that the golf ball, you know, is receiving information from, is as I swing the club, that chain reaction is my arms, my shoulders, my weight. So as the golf club starts to swing, as you can see, all I'm doing is swinging the club, my shoulder's starting to move, my weight's starting to transfer, or force is going into my right foot. So this is what needs to start the swing. Now, based on that you have the correct grip, I like to think that I'm almost throwing the face slightly to the outside. So I'm starting the momentum of the golf club by throwing the face. The reason is that I can feel the weight in the golf club when I can do that. I'm soft enough in my arms and my shoulders that if I start by throwing the face outside, it puts the weight in the club in my hands and it doesn't lock me up. I see this all the time on the lesson tee, is if my shoulders start to swing, the club goes too far to the inside. If my weight shift starts to swing, again, my bottom out point is moving off the golf ball. How I'd like you to think about it is that, again, this has the farthest to travel. So the golf club is gonna tell you a lot. As I swing back, it's gonna turn my shoulders. It's gonna tell me when my shoulders turn. To a certain extent, it's gonna tell me when the weight or the force is going into my foot. So it's a really great communicator of the swing. All I have to do is swing it. If I set the club up here and swing it back and forth, my shoulders are turning, force is going into my right foot, force is going into my left foot. And all those things are happening, and all I'm doing is making the weight of the golf club move, and all that starts to react. The other thing that happens is that, you know, I can be really soft in my arms and my shoulder sockets, so they can move. They can move athletically. Now, the reason I'd want you to throw the face is because if you have a late wrist hinge, or you feel like you set the club way too late, again, the golf swing can be very unorganized and you're getting out of sequence. If this has the farthest to travel, it has to go first. And if there's no wrist hinge, then my arms are traveling at the same rate as the face of the club. The other probably even bigger problem is that if I load the club way too late, you can see all I can feel is pressure in my forearms. I can feel the grip. I cannot feel the head of the golf club anymore. So again, try this, and that's why you see the waggle so much with really good players or on tour. Rarely do you see someone get up to the ball that's any good and go like this and try to repeat that. That's not a waggle. A waggle is feeling the weight of the golf club and making it move. So after that weight of the golf club starts moving, see, now I'm just guiding the momentum of the club. But if I never get the face going in the first place, then there's no momentum to guide. So again, how do I get my swing started? Is by throwing the face. That throwing the face sets off a chain reaction. My arms start to work, weight starts to be pulled in my right side, my shoulders start to turn, and now my body is starting to react by the momentum of the golf club. So you can start to see the entire picture of what's going on. So let's make some practice swings. Again, we can start with that loading of the wrist or throwing the face. That's why you see this so many times with players that are on TV or good players. So now as I start to throw the face, I feel how the face is thrown. Now as I start to make my swing, now I'm just guiding momentum. So you can see everything is moving in relation to the face of the club. Everything is moving in response to the face. So go ahead and hit one, So I would practice this waggle, practice throwing the face. That's how the swing's gonna start now, throw the face and let it go. So, in my opinion, throwing the face or feeling like the face of the golf club moves first is a great way to start your swing. As you swing back, everything else will start to react and start to take shape. Try this, and I hope you find this tip helpful. Like and subscribe to my channel, Billy Fitzgerald Golf. Want to take a live lesson from me? Or you have a question? Visit me at billyfitzgeraldgolf.com. And thanks for watching.